Well, it is not. It's not an original
first,
doctrine.
You don't know a single word.
It was a different kind of labyrinth. It was a kind of Cretan text. I wrote
fascinated
a kind
with
of a temple complex.
I wrote
it for
elementary
so complex.
And the meanings of the languages both in terms of their sounds.
Then as you get more familiar with it,
what it is really
the labyrinth of language and the fact that you cannot resuscitate any kind of a document and assume that you have reproduced it accurately. What you're doing is you're fictionalizing it, you're creating
a mummy.
Then I created and the
priests used to be down there and go through
for the act
incredible
language
ceremonies
all night in order to make sure that the world would continue to function.
Holy are these names, kes names zuis name with ox warner, with ok os kes names kerleps with ogela or opudsvel or of thwainuis ulfethesel, kerleps with nuib or nuisef of tedusas, ut zuis swede cars with tleif.
That's a language.
one of the things we discovered about ocean waves was that they allowing the music to kind of ebb or go into sort of a trough and then crest again.
For a long time, all facing the sunset, and watched the long parade. First of all, they were all in the different robes. They seemed to be carrying a sarcophagus. When they got a little bit closer, we saw that the sarcophagus was, in fact, on a hospital trolley, which later got stuck on a hillside. We watched this until the sunset and a CPR train went by, and we were encouraged that the Egyptians were protected by a mountie on horseback, as well as lots of joggers on bicycles. After our hillside vigil, we climbed the first of the evening's 7 million stairs to a little terrace where we saw a little excruciating modern dance recital and looked at signs promoting solar heating. We then trekked around the entire outside of the Science Center, and just as the rain was really beginning to pour down, we stood around the sarcophagus for a while, and then we were already 2.5 hours into this. We were allowed indoors. Then we saw the butcher figure who was chopping up less worthy acolytes and caught another brief glimpse of Ra, who passed through between two exit doors on his bark. Then we stood, this is a very unhappy part, in a stairwell, very cramped, and watched a ceremony involving raising of the dead. Now, almost no one could see anything, and it was very stuffy, and the music was very slow. Now, after this, we had one of the evening's true terrors, in which we were blindfolded and holding on to strangers in front and behind, led on a walk up and down some very precipitous stairs, indoors, outdoors, very steep hills. This I thought was total terror, and I thought lunatics could be leading us to the roof. And also, while we were blindfolded, people sort of tickled us with feathers and sprayed us with spritzers and touched us in unfamiliar places. Then we got into a lot of sort of encounter group stuff, which really surprised me. We were lured into a long circle and wound into a coil where we all ended up hugging each other. Yes.
And a lot of them resented it, too, particularly the critics, who didn't have the slightest idea of why they were doing these things, you know. Why am I, you know, being asked to sniff this bowl, you know, of perfume? Or why am I being asked to listen to that, you know, sound? Or why is someone feeling up my legs, you know, in the dark and all that sort of stuff? I mean, you know, you come, you embrace them or something, you know, you give them a hug, and they pull back, they stand back, you know, and look at you, you know, and or put up their hand to resist you. Yeah. I mean, because you don't embrace the critic. I mean, how can he write down the experience in his little book, you know, if he's hugging you? People would go through various kinds of ceremonies which would introduce them to a new perspective on life. And that perspective, in the case of Ra, for instance, I think there is a different perspective from the one that most people might have been thinking about before they attended it. The sun shows us that there's a continuity of all living things, but also a continuity of all dying things, and that life and death are related, not as polar opposites that always remain in opposition to one another, but as things which rotate and together form the complete experience.
So those were the, you know, some of the themes in Ra. The thing is, both arcane and very simple. I mean, we're moving towards the light. We're always moving towards the light. Through the night, we know the dawn is coming. We know that light is coming. And with that light, knowledge is coming. You know, and enlightenment is coming. And at the same time, we're surrounded by gods who are speaking a foreign language, and we're never told what it means. Although what they're saying, in fact, is perfectly apropos if you could understand it. But I don't think it matters.
Thank you. There's a lot of music in the world that it is quite obvious that peripheral listening is something that is very important in it. I'm told, for instance, in East Indian music, that you don't listen to the melodies, you listen to the drones, and you hear the melodies and the ornamentation peripherally.
You can see how different cities get energy, and they're on the move. Like Toronto's really on the move. For the first time in how many years, we have winning, to certainly not entirely successful, but we have winning sports teams. Now that may seem trivial, but if you look at the great cities of North America, you can see how there's a flux, for example, in all different aspects, sports even, and the fact that, you know, the cities, when they're great and when there's a lot of energy in those cities, they all have great sports teams. It's curious. You can look at New York, you can look at Los Angeles. I mean, you can look at any of these places and you can see that, you know, maybe it's changing. And that all of a sudden Cincinnati pops up. Thank you. I need contact with stone, wood, and water. I really do. Fire? Nah, not so much. Metal? Not so much. Those are probably already in my character to a fairly high degree. But I need those other things. I need to go out into the woods. The woods, in a way, combines all of those things because I'm surrounded by wood. I feel the rock underneath my feet, or I lay on the rock, or I climb the rock. The water, I need to get my feet wet. I need to take photographs of the water. I need to listen to the water, you know. Thank you.
I'm going to go to the hospital.